Fresh coffee aroma. So this is why you should always set a timer whenever you put anything in your oven, because I was gonna toast some really amazing peanuts this morning, and well, I did. I toasted them a lot, about an hour, and they magically look like coffee beans. So yeah, this is going to the compost pile. Hi, I'm Rick, and welcome back to Sweet Heat. I'm really excited. Actually, I'm really into this spread. It's like super beautiful. It's all fresh ingredients. I just went up to the roof and picked these tomatoes, and I also snipped this lemongrass, and I also went to a friend's house and picked this green papaya. So now let me tell you what I'm gonna make. So I love Thai food, and I miss Thai food a lot. There are not a lot of Thai restaurants here in Mazatlan. And I love those flavors because they're very much in the sweet heat camp. There's a lot of palm sugar used. There's a lot of heat from bird chilies. There's a lot of lime juice and other citrus, cilantro. It's all the flavors that I really love. And so when I was trying to decide what to make, I wanted to do something with a whole fish because I frankly feel like people don't use whole fish enough. And it's also really dramatic. Like when you put a whole fish down on the table, whether it's grilled or fried or baked, it just looks really impressive and you really didn't have to do a lot of work. And so I went for a Thai-inspired fried fish with a papaya salad. The heat in this dish, I wish I had access to Thai chilies, but I don't. So you're gonna get a double dose of heat from dried chilies and from the fresh serranos. Also, we're gonna get a little bit of heat from fresh grated ginger and fresh grated garlic. And then the sweet is going to come from palm or coconut sugar. And the fish that I'm gonna use is red snapper. I really love red snapper. Red snapper is abundant here on the Pacific coast. But I think when you go visit your market or your fishmonger, what you wanna look for is something that is really fresh that you like. Talk to the guys that are bringing in the fish or that are working with the fish and ask them what they think. And that's exactly what I did. And then even better, I asked him to prep it for me. So he took all the scales off, he washed it, he gutted it. He also cut some slits down the side, which I have written in the recipe as well. So basically I didn't have to do anything and all I'm gonna do is like prep it and fry it. Don't forget, if you like me, if you like this recipe, if you wanna see more Sweet Heat recipes, don't forget to like and subscribe and you will be notified as soon as there is another Sweet Heat episode. Okay, so the first thing we're gonna do is work on the salad, and I need a lot of fresh lime juice. So these are key limes, my favorite, also very common here in Mexico. And this is 5 tablespoons of lime juice or 1/3 of a cup. Can you get like a slow-mo of the drip?
Is that weird?
Getting all extra in here. So now we're going to add some garlic. So I'm using 4 garlic cloves, and I'm just gonna grate this right into the measuring cup. Now the ginger. This is about 1 tablespoon of ginger. I'm not really worried about measuring this just because I love ginger, so if it's a little bit more, then I'm not gonna be really upset. This is about 1-inch piece, and it's about 3/4 of an inch thick. That's gonna give me about 1 tablespoon of ginger, maybe a little bit more. And I'm gonna go ahead and grate this directly into the measuring cup. Okay. And then I also love this tool for grating lemongrass. You're gonna extract the maximum amount of flavor. You're going to completely pulverize the lemongrass, and so you're not gonna have any big chunks. It's not gonna get stuck in anybody's teeth. It's gonna be a very pleasant sauce. So now I'm gonna add some lime zest to really get the flavor of the citrus, or at least the flavor that you're smelling. You really need to use the zest. So this is 1 teaspoon of lime zest. Now I'm using fish sauce, because we need some salt and we need some umami. All right, so that's 3 tablespoons of fish sauce. All right, so I'm gonna add the sugar. Because I'm using the coconut sugar is not quite as sweet as straight up either brown or white granulated sugar. So you may need to add a little bit more. So I would start with the 3 tablespoons, whisk it in and just see what it tastes like. And then you can always add more, but I feel like probably 4 is where I'm gonna need to be, but I will taste it to make sure. It smells so good. Oh. Mm. Oof. It's got a little kick. Yeah, I think actually maybe 4.5, just because I like things on the sweet side, but you make it to your palate. Also, I mean, another thing to remember is that the green papaya is not gonna have really any sweetness to it. It's gonna be much more on the tart side. So all of your sugar is gonna come from this dressing. Okay. Mm, oof, that's good. Okay. Also very strong. Okay, so I'm really excited because I'm going to finally use my molcajete. This is a Mexican mortar and pestle. It's made with lava rock. I obviously already showed you how to use the microplane. I find that that gives you a really nice fine grate that I think is really good for the sauce. But I also like using the mortar and pestle for something that I want to have a little bit more texture, something that's gonna be a little more coarse. So I'm using dried chilies. I'm actually gonna use quite a few since it's fun and I like heat. I don't want these to be in a powder. If I stood here for a really long time, I would eventually get them pretty fine. I wanna see bits of the chili. It is actually starting to hit the back of my throat now, but that's good. The show isn't called Sweet Mild. All right, I want you to smell this. I want you to cough. Whatever. Now I'm gonna just lightly crush some of the peanuts. I'm gonna leave some, maybe a little bit more whole for garnish. Oh, wait, so the peanuts got you, but the chili de árbol didn't. Okay, I see how this is. All right, I'm gonna trim these beans really quick. This is about 1/2 pound of beans. I'm just gonna cut them in half. I like the raw beans, but I do feel like for this dish, you want them to soften up and absorb a little bit more of the dressing. And so to me, the best way to do that is just to give them a little crush. I don't need to pulverize them. I'm really just looking for that. They're just slightly opened up and they're gonna hold on to more of that sauce. The sauce is going to penetrate. It's going to actually cook them in the same way that a lime juice or an acid would cook ceviche or fish. So another ingredient that I'm using, and this is common both in Mexico and also in Thai cuisine, are dried shrimp. These are dried out in the sun and they're really, really flavorful and delicious. They have both the head and the tail on. You can grind them in a mortar and pestle or you can put them in a food processor or a spice grinder. I actually have some ground shrimp powder that I actually, I like that. Because I feel like, especially with the shell, you can get a little piece of shell that's not gonna get really ground, or I would have to stand here for a really long time to grind it up. So it's kind of a cheat. I'm gonna use that. And it's really, really good. Okay, so that's done. And the longer that that sits, I wouldn't let go crazy. I wouldn't let it sit for hours and hours, but another like hour or two is gonna help develop those flavors. All of the flavors are gonna combine. It's gonna mellow out ever so slightly, but it's gonna combine to make a really, really deliciously balanced and intense dressing for the salad. All right, so last ingredient, the star of this particular dish is the green papaya. So a green papaya is not gonna be soft and silky and velvety like a ripe papaya is. So if you can't find a green papaya, or if all the papaya are ripe in your grocery store, you can also use a green mango. But if you can find a green papaya, and as you can see, it is green on the outside and orange on the inside. Traditionally, this would be very green. The interior would be green as well, and it would be a little bit more tart. I am going to just use a vegetable peeler to peel the skin off. It's actually pretty easy. It's like peeling a sweet potato. So what I'm gonna do is I'm just going to thinly slice the papaya. It does require a sharp knife. So these are probably about an eighth of an inch thick. Then you just stack these up and then you cut the other way. I don't think I've had to julienne anything since culinary school. And this is the cut that you're looking for. Just really, really thin, beautiful strips. And now I'm chopping my fresh from the rooftop tomatoes. So now we're gonna pick up the same flavors that are in the salad in the fish. Ordinarily, I wouldn't do this because I feel like then your food starts to get redundant and flavors start to flatten out. But because we're eating the salad completely raw and we're gonna be tasting all of those ingredients in their raw state, and because we're frying the fish and all of those other flavors are gonna cook, you'll get a completely different flavor profile from both dishes, even though we're using almost the identical ingredients in both. The reason why I didn't write them together to make a big double batch is because in case you wanna make the papaya salad separately from the fish, you wouldn't have a double batch. But if you're gonna do them together, you might as well make a double batch and just split it up, use half for the fish, half for the salad. If you're like me and you use a lot of ginger, you end up with this, like little nubbins of ginger, like random leaves of lemongrass, a couple of random cloves of garlic attached to the end of a head. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna use these. We're gonna be frying this fish. And one of the things that I just recently discovered is that if you flavor the oil, if you put all of these little scraps in and into cold oil and then bring it slowly up to temp, you'll actually create this really amazing oil infusion. It's gonna add so much flavor to whatever you're cooking. And so it's just another way that we're gonna add a little bit more flavor, a little more depth, another layer to this amazing fish. Okay, so these are my beautiful snapper. This is just under 2 pounds. They're pretty small, but I feel like this is gonna feed 4 people. So all that you really need to do, and because this is a smaller fish, I only have 4 cuts total. You basically just want to open it up a little bit. And so what I usually do is make slits about 2 inches apart down the length of both sides of the fish. What that does is it helps the fish cook a little bit more evenly, but more importantly, because I've got this little quick marinade, I'm gonna get all of that ginger and chili de árbol and lemongrass and garlic into the slits so that it can actually flavor the flesh of the fish. I'm gonna season this first, and I'm gonna use the protein hand to go in and make sure that I'm getting the salt inside the little cuts. And you also wanna open it up and make sure you season the interior of the fish. And then I will flip it and do the same thing. So now for the marinade, I'm just gonna go in, same thing as before with the salt. I don't really care that if it's sitting on the skin, I don't necessarily need it there. It's not gonna penetrate the flesh on the skin. Where it's gonna penetrate is in the cuts and inside the fish. So I'm just gonna use my hands and just kind of stuff it into the cuts. I'm also really just scooping up the solids. The lime juice is really there to create a paste, but I don't need any excess liquid on the fish because we're gonna fry it. And the only thing that the liquid is going to do is prevent us from getting a crust, or the liquid is going to be absorbed by the flour and you're gonna have a very acidic and limey crust. So this is gonna hang out for about 15 minutes. That time is great to then bring up your oil temperature slowly up to 325. I'm gonna add the aromatics so that we can like pull out all of those amazing flavors as well. Okay, let's go flavor some oil. So this is about a quart or 4 cups of oil. And so I'm just gonna drop all of this in there. Basically what I want, I gave you a measured amount of oil, but really what you want is the oil to come halfway up the side of the pan. So this you can see is pretty much perfect. All right, so here are my aromatics. Basically all the flavors that you like You can throw those in there. I'm gonna go ahead and put this on low just to slowly bring things up. And when the ginger starts to go golden brown and everything is starting to bubble, that means that you're right around 325 degrees and that's the perfect temp to cook the fish. So the first thing that we're gonna do is prep the fish. So I'm just going to push it down on both sides with a paper towel. All I wanna do is like just soak up any of this excess lime juice or the condensation on the fish. Looks really good. I also put it on a rack just so that any excess lime juice or any juices would just fall directly in the tray. We'll give this a turn and blot it. Okay. And now whatever excess moisture is there, we're going to coat it with a little bit of flour. So in the recipe, I wrote about a cup of flour. And so what I'm gonna do is take a half a cup and put it in a sifter. And then I just wanna lightly dust each fish. I don't want like a super thick crust, but I just want to give us a little bit of a crunch on the outside. You just want like a little light dusting of snow. And then we'll turn it over. So this is exactly how you want the oil to look. So if you didn't have an instant read thermometer, once you see the garlic and the ginger start to turning brown, that means you're right around temp. It's not going crazy. It's certainly not very dark, but that is exactly the way that you want it. So it's exactly around 325. Now I'm going to take my fish. I'm just gonna give it a little bit of a tap to get the excess flour off. And then we will come over and we'll drop them in. I'm gonna turn the heat up now. It's been on low. This way, as soon as I drop the fish in, the temp of the oil is gonna drop. So stick the front end down and then just lay it down in the center of the pan. Once this is cooked for a few minutes, the flesh will get a little bit soft and I'll be able to like twist the tail into the oil. Probably no one is going to want to eat the tail, but I do want it to get a little bit fried and brown so that it looks like the rest of the fish and it doesn't have raw flour on it. Turning it. So this is probably the trickiest part. Don't be scared. As long as you turn it away from you, nothing bad is going to happen. I like doing this with tongs. I can grip it and then I can like stabilize the fish with a spat. Because this is small, I actually feel like I can turn it, yeah, just like that. That was really easy. And actually, it's really beautiful. Okay, so my timer just went off and also both sides are beautifully golden brown. So I'm going to pull the fish out. Oh, it's so good. And now I'm going to drop the second one in. I'm gonna finish the salad now, and I've got some really beautiful cilantro. I'm gonna leave the leaves whole because I like seeing them. If you wanna chop them, you can, but I think it just looks prettier if they're whole. And I'm gonna put some mint in mine as well. I just love the combination of cilantro and mint. Also, the mint I'm growing upstairs on the roof, so might as well use it. It looks really pretty. These leaves I'm gonna break up a little bit because they are so strong. Now, I'm just gonna give these scallions a little quick chop. Now we're going to finish the salad. So basically I'm putting everything that I've just prepped into everything. So half of this is going to go in the salad and half of it's going to go in the top of the fish. I'm just gonna take some of my herbs, actually probably a little more than half because I like a nice herby salad. I'm gonna put some of the serrano in here as well, because why not? Some of the scallion, because why not? And I'm gonna put this amazing dressing, which I'm so super excited to eat. And this is a Thai-inspired whole fried fish with an almost green papaya salad. It's so perfectly cooked. It's like just falling off the bones. It's like really, really moist and tender. I'm gonna just try the fish by itself because I just wanna make sure that it's like properly seasoned for you. Oh, it's so good. Oh my God. Just the fish alone. I'm getting a nice little heat. I can taste the ginger, a little bit of the lemongrass, but the lemongrass and the lime are kind of playing nicely off of each other. So they're like one is blending into the other. Now this bite, I'm gonna get some salad in there. Mm. This is so good. This is exactly what I wanna eat on the beach with a really cold beer, watching the waves crash in. The thing that you need to do is just make this dish and enjoy it. Pretend you're at the beach, pretend it's summertime, pretend it's warm. You are going to absolutely love it. I'm gonna go in for more. And don't forget, if you like this video, if you like me, if you like this series, make sure you hit like and subscribe. And as soon as there's another Sweet Heat episode, you will be notified.
Sit. Good boy, good boy. Do it nicely to get a sponsor for dog treats.
Does your dog have shrimp breath?